you would collaborate maybe again with some Bostic or Mike Mosley, like they did back in the day, and how it was to work with them?
Man, it's an unbelievable experience to be able to be in the room with those type of dudes that make music the way they do and been connected to so many legendary people and to know them on a personal level. It's just like, you know, it's definitely one of my inspirations and helps me, motivate me to be the best I could be.
No, the stuff in mob shit, like Darrell or Studio Town or...
Yep. K-Lou still mixes all my music. Everything, if you go listening, you go to my Spotify or my whatever, all the music I didn't drop in the last year, K-Lou mixed it, you know what I mean? I got an EP that's actually produced by Mike Mosley that's going to be dropping this year, too.
Man, see, that's the dope thing that you guys are able to still work together after all these years. It shows the loyalty, the brotherhood, you know what I'm saying, that you guys have. That's dope. You know,
man, as far as Mike Mosley go, that's my brother. Like I was there when he produced Gas Chamber. You feel me? Like I was there when he was making the music for Gas Chamber before Sebo even rapped on any of the songs. You feel me? Like that's the type of roots and history I got with some of these people. You know what I'm saying?
You know?
Like, I ain't making this up. You feel me? Like, this is all real events that's really happened. No depletions, no nothing. This is all real events. You feel me? Like, I fucked with these cats back in the day because I was the young nigga that was around all these cats. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. Just soaking up a lot of games.
And all that.
And a lot of historical stuff.
Man.
Now,
one day
we're hearing those Gas Chamber beats. Do you want those for yourself?
I mean, I was, to be honest with you, you remember that song, Where You Get That Scratch From?
Yeah.
On Sebo Gas Chamber album, I was supposed to be on that. I had a verse written, everything, but that was right before I went to Juvenile Hall. I went to Juvenile Hall right before I was supposed to record my verse, and then by the time I got out, I was in there 30 days. And when I got out, the album was done. But I was supposed to be, that's one of my regrets, so. Like, if I had to ask me if I regret anything, that's definitely one of my regrets, is getting in trouble and not being able to be on that historical album. You feel me? Because Alpizo would have been on the Gas Chamber. You feel me? But it is what it is.
Make sure to subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell for notifications. Like, comment, share. Also, go over to UGSForLife.com, download the entire archive, and check out new episodes on Apple Podcasts and Blog Talk Radio.